basically taking you to a secret. Well, it's not even a secret, it's a hidden bar not many people know about. You go through Manchester Airport, you literally go straight over the first two roundabouts, and then you're going to go left. And I'm going to show you in a second where it is. Basically, it's called the Airport Pub. I don't know why no one ever goes there. Like, well, I feel like if you're from Manchester, you'll know about it. If you're from Manchester, you'll have been there. But I always talk about it to my mates, and none of them seem to have been there. So I figure it's not as common knowledge as I thought it was. So I'm going to head there today, and I'm going to showcase how sick this bar is. Right, look. Look out the window. So basically, at this roundabout, you go left. It's pretty easy. And then over this next one, straight over. Then you're going to follow this road right round until you see a pub on your right hand side. Sick is this? You can literally sit in a beer garden, have a beer, watch planes taking off. Like, amazing. It's like the best place, my most favorite place in Manchester to hang out. How's it going? Welcome back. Do you know what? I was just thinking to myself, I have literally nothing happening this week. There's literally nothing interesting to vlog. I'm sat here going, I'm literally sat here right now working on a testimonial video I filmed the other day. I even caught it on camera. I don't know if anyone thought I'd be interested. I was just like, hey, why not? And do you know what was quite cool? I went to a little pub yesterday and I sort of filmed the whole like journey to this pub, and that's like a secret hidden pub. It's not hidden, like it's not secret, but a lot of people don't know about it. And it's a pub you can go and sit in the garden, you can watch the airplanes land and sort of dream about the startup of your travel company, or maybe sit there and swear at people on the plane and be like screw you and hope it rains when you land sort of thing. So I shared that, and I woke up this morning and it had, I think it's like 300 and odd thousand, I think it's nearly 400,000 views on Facebook. And I was like, what the fuck? Because Facebook is like, to me, a dead platform. Like, I don't even use it really. I just share on there occasionally with my family to see stuff. I'm just looking now. It's on 400,000 views on Facebook. What in the fuck? And I looked at like Instagram and TikTok and even LinkedIn. Between the lot of them, I think it's like nearly 500,000 views of this little pub in Manchester, which will, by the way, be rammed this weekend. It has to be after that. And loads of people loving it. And I'm thinking to myself, you know, I started vlogging because I wanted to catch cool events on camera whilst abroad, right? And I wanted to share these things with people who might want to go and do them themselves. And I thought, why not just do it in the UK right now? I can't go abroad. You know, we're stuck here anyway because of stupid coronavirus. So why not just try and capture some awesome things and film them anyway? Find things in the UK. Like maybe make the best ultimate days out or whatever. Just like things that fit in around work. And when I do have things to record for work, I'll go out and capture that as well. Because obviously, part of the diary is, you know, it says business, travel, but adventure as well. I didn't want to be boring. I didn't want to be focused on business. So with that in mind, I saw there was an event coming to Manchester, like a scare fest sort of thing, which you drive-in cinema, obviously, because coronavirus, you can't really have gatherings, so a drive-in cinema is fantastic, right? You stay in your own car. And then I was like, what is this thing? It turns out they have like live actors, and they have like a tunnel you drive through. They've got a haunted house, stuff like that. And I thought, how cool is that? And it's in Manchester. So I messaged them like, hey, I'd love to come down and check it out. And they've said yes. So that might be the next part of this video. I don't know where if I'm going to be going. It's supposed to be today. They're going to confirm it. But if I do go, I'll vlog it. And it looks quite cool. So yeah, man, that's what I'd say. I guess not all vlogs have to be me out in the wild world trying to catch something cool. Sometimes this is all working for yourself is sat at a fucking kitchen table, smashing away on a laptop, and just grafting away. So that's what I'm doing today. And maybe if I get an invite, I'll go tonight and catch that cool haunted event, and it'll look quite decent. But if I do, I'll make a TikTok out of it again, because yeah, man, 500,000 views, that is ridiculous. But I think people just want to see fun stuff. People just want to come up with cool ideas, right? So maybe I'll find other stuff in the UK to do as well. Who knows? Yeah, that's my thoughts for today so far. I'll guess you'll see if I end up going to a haunted event. Just pulled up outside the Scare City place. I'm excited. Dom, how you feel about it all?
Ooh, it's going to be good. It's going to be good.
Happy birthday, Freya. Yeah, man, we don't know what to expect. We're thinking it's gonna be quite exciting, but yeah, it'll be interesting. Dead scary stuff down here. Event City's been transformed. Look around, man. So they've got multiple screens set up. It's like a drive-in cinema. And everyone has to drive through this horror tunnel on the way in. It shits you right up and that. You can watch on the screen there behind me. It literally films people driving in. Social media already, and loads of people are going, oh, I'm gonna book. I would recommend it to anyone. Basically, you're driving, you have to go through some sort of little horror car wash where people jump out of here, banging on the windows, trying to get in a car. While you sat there, there's people running around. If you go for a piss, you get chased across the car park. At one point, I'm pretty sure I saw him cover a car up with a tarp, start shaking it. Someone set fire to someone else's car, like, insane. Definitely worth doing. I'm glad that I got one on camera. I don't even know how I'm going to put it together in a vlog, but yeah, it'll be interesting. It might break up the week a little bit. And then tomorrow, back to work. For now, peace out, guys. Hi, everybody. What the hell is going on? I just flick on to my Facebook page to have a nosy at how the video is doing, and it's got 1.2 million views. That is insane. Like, that is actually insane. I think I might actually have to go back and get some cool shots to put in this vlog. But oh my god, I don't know, like, I'm left thinking to myself, maybe should I start going doing some more cool events and checking some stuff out, like what actually makes a good vlog. I got invited to some other drive-thru horror fest next week. I might actually go to that as well now and just check it out. But how cool is that? So all I have to do is find cool events, cool things that people like, and share them. I mean, that's the whole point of Hidden Travel, right? Hidden Travel was designed around finding cool activities, events, hotels. Obviously, we can't travel right now, but maybe whilst I'm in the UK, I might just start vlogging all this sort of stuff. But fuck me, 1.2 million views. They sold out for the entire month, like, and they've just put an extra week on, all because of one little video. And I've not even put it on YouTube yet. This video is being taken before I actually share it on YouTube. Insane. Anyway, yeah, I'm thinking that I might actually do that. Try and find cool things that I absolutely love and share with people. Maybe give them some ideas on what they should do as well with their kids or families. And yeah, just thought I'd update and say what the fuck is going on. Oh, and on top of that, I just sold another client. We've got another website build, another couple of months worth of work. Yeah, man, today's a fucking weird day, but it's a good day. So yeah, just sharing.
Woo!
What a week, what a week. Do you know what? I thought I'd have nothing interesting to capture yet. This week I've managed to find a cool secret bar, shared that out, got about 500,000 views, well, just over, dead happy with that. It's a cool bar, they're booked up for the weekend, so that's banging. Went out and went to a Halloween drive-through cinema, which is pretty cool. I'm not really into Halloween events, but getting sort of like something different like in your day, I thought, why not go and check it out? It was quite cool, it was a little bit scary. I've actually been told there's some sort of other sort of drive-through Halloween thing happening, which I might go and check out next week. Here's something interesting for you. I think as of right now, that Halloween video I put together is on 1.8 million views. Can you fucking... 1.8 million. That we were talking about this earlier on. It's like 19 Wembley stadiums full of people. It's like almost the entire population of Greater Manchester. Every single person has seen that video, which goes to show the event is pretty cool, it's pretty sick, so I hope them guys do well. They told me that they've sold out loads of days, they've had to put an extra week on, and there's no one else promoting it but me, and I didn't even mean to, so yeah, buzzing at that. One thing is very interesting, I'm sat here right now, and I start getting a message from my little sister, and she goes, look at Misguided's Facebook, so I'm on Misguided, my video's on there, they've cropped my name out, and they posted it as their own, like Happy Halloween with a link to their fucking shop. I was like, what is this? Then I went on Twitter, same on Twitter and Instagram. They posted my video everywhere and cropped my name out of it. I was like, excuse me. Do you know, I don't mind. You want to use a video? Fantastic. Use it. Fantastic. Just make sure you tag me, because I was the guy that took the time out to go and find something quite cool. I was the guy that sat and edited it for a couple of hours. And I was the guy that shared it with my friends and followers. And to just nick it and post it, I was like, you cheeky bastards. So, yeah, I just messaged him. I was on Twitter like, hey, excuse me, you're a bunch of fuckers. Do you mind crediting me? I posted that out. So they fixed it. So that's not too bad. They're not too snide. But I mean, that is pretty snaky, the fact that I had to find it myself. Especially when it was like doing so well. You know, like I never get like decent video views. So to have one that's doing quite well and that everyone really liked, it's nice to actually say, oh, you know, Lewis made this. Anyway, that aside, I just wanted to sort of round off the week. It's been very interesting, it's been very cool. I've got a lot of work done. I managed to pick up a new client this week. To be honest, I'm absolutely swamped. I don't know when I'm gonna get a chance to do the next vlog in, but I'm gonna keep the camera close to me and try and capture everything. And hopefully you're interested, and I might go and try and find some more cool things to do. Next week I'll definitely hit up that Halloween event and capture that on camera, because that sounds quite cool, and it's not just a cinema, it's like an actual event. So yeah, watch this space. See you later, guys.